worship for our pre-recorded service for July 19th, the seventh Sunday after Pentecost. Let's begin worship with the red hymnal number 609, and we will sing verses 1 and 5. Again, today, elements of the worship service are available online, so the Sunday school opening and the children's chat as usual, and our sermon today from Pastor Karl, assistant to the bishop, also presented in a separate video today. We continue with worship using the order for confession and forgiveness on page 2 in your bulletin. We confess our sins before God and one another. Loving God, when our path becomes difficult, we do not always turn to you. We look for an easy way out. We escape in avoidance and addiction. We forget your promises and seek what does not satisfy. Forgive us and bring us back into the strength of your Spirit. God is generous and loving and forgiving. Hear and believe that your sins are washed away and that new life is yours through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. In the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
And we pray together the prayer of the day. Gracious God, you call us to show the same forgiveness to others which you have shown to us. Enlarge our hearts to accept those who have wronged us, and grant us all your Spirit of healing and compassion for the sake of Jesus Christ. Amen. Again today, look for the children's chat on a separate video on Zion's email or social media.
The reading today is from the second Corinthians chapter 2. So I made up my mind not to make you another painful visit. For if I cause you pain, who is there to make me glad but the one whom I have pained? And I wrote as I did, so that when I came, I might not such a person. So now instead, you should forgive and console him, so that he may not be overwhelmed by excessive sorrow. So I urge you to reaffirm your love for him. I wrote for this reason, to test you, and to know whether you are obedient in everything. Anyone whom you forgive, I also forgive. What I have forgiven, if I have forgiven anything, has been for your sake in the presence of Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Last week and this week, strange circumstances where we've divided worship into two parts and the second part is provided by the Senate staff, we've added thanksgiving for the word. This is from the red hymnal and a nice prayer for the action of God's word in our lives. Let us pray. Praise and thanks to you, Holy God, for by your word you made all things. You spoke light into darkness, called forth beauty from chaos, and brought life into being. For your word of life, O God, we give you thanks and praise. By your word, you called your people Israel to tell of your wonderful gifts, freedom from captivity, water on the desert journey, a pathway home from exile, wisdom for life with you. For your word of life, O God, we give you thanks and praise. Through Jesus, your word made flesh, you speak to us and call us to witness. Forgiveness through the cross, life to those entombed by death, the way of your self-giving love. For your word of life, O God, we give you thanks and praise. Send your spirit of truth, O God, to rekindle your gifts within us. Renew our faith, increase our hope, and deepen our love for the sake of a world in need. Faithful to your word, O God, draw near to all who call on you. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory forever.
Amen.
We sing together the hymn of the day in the ELW, the red hymnal number 836. We sing verses 1 and 3. Apostles' Creed, confessing our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. pray for the church, the world, and all those in need.
O Lord, when we harm our relationships, everyone suffers, and your heart is grieved. Give us courage and mercy to repent where we have wronged others, and to forgive others where they have wronged us. Guide us to focus on unity and service, especially with youth and family ministries and all who are preparing to be married. Forgiving God,
hear our prayer.
Strengthen and protect victims of abuse and mistreatment, that they might eventually be able to release the chains of their past and live in the freedom that you have promised through your Spirit. Forgiving God,
hear our prayer.
The damage we have done to our planet, we have also done to ourselves. Creator God, in the form of diminishing resources, polluted air and water, and abnormal weather patterns, have mercy on our foolishness and give us wisdom to turn from our selfish and destructive behaviors. Forgiving God,
hear our prayer.
We isolate ourselves in many ways, from the community and from you. Lord, restore us to wholeness of body and soul by your healing Spirit. Be present with all those who need you most, especially all affected by the coronavirus and all who are helping others, all affected by racial injustice. Volke, Adrian, Arliss, Paul, Jeff, Bill, Bella, Kathy, Bill, and all those we name out loud and in our hearts. Forgiving God,
hear our prayer.
We thank you for all who have walked this earth with us, but are no longer with us physically. Preserve us in the hope of seeing them again in your heavenly kingdom. Keep us close in spirit until that day, and bring comfort to those who mourn. Forgiving God,
hear our prayer.
We know that you have heard us, O God, the prayers we speak aloud and those for which we cannot find words. Gather all of our concerns and keep all people in your care for the sake of your Savior, Jesus. Amen.
Amen. We pray together as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Peace be with you, and thanks to you all who are offering generously of your time, talents, and treasures for Zion and for the community beyond us. And we pray together as we lift all those offerings up to the Lord's service. We offer these gifts not out of guilt for our misdeeds, but out of generosity toward the children whom you love. Accept and bless them in the spirit by which they are given, moving us to focus more on others than ourselves, for the sake of your kingdom on earth. Amen. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever. Thank you again to all who have made worship possible, for Ellen and Barb and Paul today, for Karl, Biermann, assistant to the bishop, for providing the sermon for the part two of today's worship. Again, please watch that part two online. Check the Synod website, and we will also transmit that through Zion's website and email and social media. Similar with the Sunday school opening and the children's chat, those are available in separate videos. Today is the second of two Sundays where we are pre-recording worship. Next Sunday, July 26th, we will be back on the schedule that we were before. So the 8:30 service will be outdoors. You can check messages for that on precautions to take if you come to that. And the 10:45 service will be just a few people who are needed to make it happen and live streamed back to the way we had done a few weeks ago. Next week also after worship, congregational meeting shortly after approximately 11:45 call the care team or call Heike during office hours, and they do have local pastors on call to help if needed. Our second hymn for today is number 779 in the red hymnal. We will sing verses 1 and 4. Please do look for part two of worship today from Pastor Karl Biermann, assistant to the bishop. And once you have watched that, go in peace. Serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.